In this Black History moment, the Ask Diamond Show honors a producer, writer, actor, and one of the best film directors of our generation.
Yeah.
Mr. Spike Lee.
What's up? This is Spike Lee.
Shelton Jackson Lee was born in Atlanta, Georgia, March 20th, 1957. To Jacqueline Carol Shelton, a teacher of arts and black literature, and William James Edward Lee III, a jazz musician and composer. As a small child, he moved with his family to Brooklyn, New York.
My parents bought this brownstone across the street from Fort Greene Park between Myrtle and Willoughby.
His mother nicknamed him Spike. While he had the pleasure and experience of growing up in Fort Greene, he returned to Georgia to take film courses at Clark Atlanta University and Morehouse College. During a summer break, he couldn't find a job and didn't want to be bored, so he borrowed a friend's camera and ran around New York City filming. He made a story of the footage and called it Last Hustle in Brooklyn. Returning to his visionary roots in New York, the Fort Greene neighborhood is home to Lee's production company, 40 Acres and a Mule Filmworks. In 1985, Lee began work on his first feature film, She's Gotta Have It. With a budget of $175,000, the black and white film was shot in 2 weeks. When the film was released in 1986, it grossed over $7 million. The brand of 40 Acres and a Mule Filmworks expanded greatly. Through the marketing wing, Lee directed commercials for Levi's, Converse, Jaguar, Taco Bell, and Ben & Jerry's. A sneaker company hired him to direct a commercial based on the Mars Blackman character in a campaign for the Air Jordan line, which took him to another level of success.
Nike took off.
Enough said. But his passion was film. Films that examined race relations, the role of media, urban crime, poverty, and other political issues. 40 Acres gave a whole generation of young people access to the film industry. It helped launch the careers of numerous young production staff and black actors. Wesley Snipes, Mekhi Phifer, Denzel Washington, Samuel L. Jackson, and Halle Berry. Even Al Sharpton and Nelson Mandela appeared in a Spike Lee joint. Malcolm X.
It was a unique moment in history.
Spike Lee took the film industry by storm. There was Clockers and Girl 6, but I know you remember Get on the Bus, a film about 15 men taking a bus trip to the Million Man March. And my favorite part, the Shabuya roll call.
Shabuya, Shabuya roll call.
Name is Pop.
Yeah.
Pop. We at the top.
Yeah.
Not all this Shabuya.
Yeah.
I got the style.
Brooklyn's in the house.
Spike always keeps his family first. His sister, Joa Lee, has appeared in many of his films. She also co-wrote and produced Crooklyn. His father, Bill Lee, has composed original music for many of his soundtracks, including world-renowned artists Prince, Brandon Marsalis, and Stevie Wonder. Spike Lee has produced numerous TV shows and over 35 thought-provoking films.
I can always tell when my films work the best is the conversation is generated.
He's more than just a director, he's a documentary writer. In 2000, Lee directed comedy documentary film, The Original Kings of Comedy. There were several hits that came since he began. Then in 2012, there was Red Hook Summer.
Red Hook Summer is another, I would say, installment about my chronicles of Brooklyn, New York, which I love so dearly.
Filmmaking found Spike Lee. He didn't find it. He didn't start directing films to be famous or earn a lot of money. He did it because he found something he loved. He followed his passion and made the right choice in his career path. So it's all about
the choices people make and the consequences of those choices.
The irony that Spike Lee graduated from Morehouse is that they shunned him and never asked him back.
Nobody.
Now he's on the board of trustees. Professor Lee also teaches at NYU and remains the artistic director at his film school, the 40 Acres Institute, located in Brooklyn, of course, because
there's a whole lot of history.
To those interested in film, the 40 Acres Institute offers a film program that demystifies filmmaking.
Yeah, I know about that.
The 40 Acres brand and Spike Lee joints have become so large that his name is mentioned in rap songs.
Stank-ass rappers make me sick.
You gotta love his humility.
Continuing ongoing struggle.
His skills.
My skills as a documentary filmmaker has helped my narrative filmmaking. My narrative filmmaking skills have helped my documentary.
And his advice.
Get it while you can get it.
Spike Lee has mastered the formula. What is it?
Storytelling. That's, for me, that's the most important thing as a filmmaker.
One thing that's undeniable is his signature shot, the dolly shot. Then you know that you are watching a Spike Lee joint. He is the dolly shot wizard, the master of keeping you focused.
That's what we need.
Being a diehard Knicks fan, you can always catch a glimpse of him courtside in the Garden or at a Yankees game. No matter where he goes, devoted fans always ask,
Yo, what's the next joint? What's the next joint? So
it's coming as his creative juices flow into your next conversation after a Spike Lee joint on the big screen from the mind of a Brooklyn boy.
Well, BK all day.
So we pay homage and honor a brilliant producer, phenomenal documentary writer, extraordinary actor, and one of the most significant film directors of our time. How is that?
Well, I think that if one looks at the body of my work so far, I think it's very diverse.
So we honor Mr. Spike Lee.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Yeah?
Any words of inspiration you want to leave us with?
Go with God.
With this Black History moment, I'm Diamond for the Ask Diamond Show.
You can never tell what's in a man's mind. And if he's from Harlem, there's no use of even trying. Just like the tide, his mind comes and goes. Like much weather when he'll change. Nobody knows, nobody knows. The man I love, well, he just turned me down. He's a Harlem Brown. Oftentimes I wish that I were in this crowd, 6 feet underground. He idolized me as no other could. No, no. Then he surprised me, leaving me a note saying he's gone for good. And since my sweetie left me hollow, well, it ain't the same old place. Though a thousand dandies smile. Drive up these mean old Harlem blues. You can have your Broadway, give me Lenox Avenue. Angels from the skies, draw seven, think of that.
This is a Diamond Life production.
If you want to be happy, have a happy life, and not be miserable, find something that you love. That's it.
BK all day.